High performance logging in .NET, does it worth it? Let's find that out. Hello and welcome to Code with Sar. I'm Sar. How are you doing? When I was doing the research for the last video, and yes, I did do research for my videos, I came across this high performance logging in .NET post, and since it has a high performance in its title, I spent some time to read it. Basically, it provides a way to predefine the logging information, set the parameters upfront, so that when logging happens, especially for multiple times, it uses the predefined information and gain the performance. There are two things that makes me curious. How much gain are we talking about here? And what's the catch? For me, those are important because every time when I use those lower performance logging, I need to know what I'm losing. And I hope this video could provide a way for us to find out answers for questions like those. Let's dive in. Here's my benchmark plan. On the iLogger, I'm going to run the normal logging that will be used as a baseline to compare. And then there will be the high performance logging. Actually, there will be two of them. One without extension method and one with extension method. I'll explain the differences on the way. And I'll run the benchmark twice. Once without any logging provider. And the purpose of that is to see the bare bone performance gain. And then the second time, I'll put a console logging provider there, and that will be closer to a real scenario. Let's get started. Let me start with the results, in case that's the only thing that you're interested in. I'm not going to waste your time. On the table, each row stands for the method, normal logging, high performance logging, and high performance logging with extension method. The second columns are the means when it runs without any provider. As we can see, there are actually 30%-ish gain there. But when it runs with the console provider, the performance is effectively the same. One thing that I want to point out is the units in the table are different. Logging runs very fast in range of nanoseconds when there's no provider. When the console provider steps in, it slows everything down. So here's my conclusion. When it runs in production environment, it's probably not worth doing the high performance logging. But please don't take my words. Coming next, I'll show you how do I get those numbers, so you will be able to form your own opinion. To do the benchmark, I'm going to leverage a package named benchmark.net. So the first step is to add the reference to the package. By the way, as you can see, I also have already added the reference to some of the logging providers. Then I created this logging benchmark class for the benchmark runner to use. In the constructor, I did the preparations. Here I created a logger factory. And then I use the logger factory to create a logger. And that's the logger we're going to use for benchmarking. Now, like we planned, I'm going to do three benchmarks. I named the first one logging, marked it with benchmark attribute, and in the body, just call log information on the logger that we created in the constructor. I'm going to return a boolean of true here just in case the method got be optimized. In the log information method, the first parameter is event ID. The second is a string format. It is extracted to its own constant just because I want to use the exact same message format or in all three benchmarks. And last, create a random string method generates a random string that will fill up the placeholder in the string format. Now for the second benchmark, high perf logging, it takes in the string by create a random string method, and the logging message format as well as the event ID had already been predefined. I'll explain more about it later, but for now, let's focus on how to forming up the benchmark class. The syntax for calling the high performance logging is not that favorable, and that's why we usually provide the high performance logging in form of an extension method in the benchmark number 3. What you're seeing there is we're calling log high perf info directly on iLogger. And that method named log high perf info is just an extension method on the instance of iLogger. And that is pretty much it. We created a class for the benchmark. We used the constructor to prepare the benchmarking. We have three methods to do the benchmarks. Let's see how we get it running. To run the benchmark we defined in logging benchmark class, we are going to use a class named benchmark runner. It is provided in the package benchmark.net and in the namespace of benchmark.net.running. Here on line 9, we just call benchmark runner.run and give it the class that contains the benchmarks. The runner will pick up the class, discovering all the methods that is marked as benchmark, and execute them. Here's how it looks like when it runs. Oh, by the way, to make the readout close to the production system, it is recommended to use the configuration of release to run all the benchmarks. Here you see the benchmarks running, and I'm going to fast forward it to the end for obvious reasons. Here we go, those are the summaries. Now I'm going to explain how is the high performance logging implemented. If you are not interested, feel free to like my video, subscribe to my channel, and go! Okay, coming back, the way to do it is called the LoggerMessage pattern. And the core of the pattern is on line 12. It's a define method on LoggerMessage class. The define method takes in a type parameter, and that is a type for the logging object. Compared to those normal logging method, this one predefines the type of the arguments. So there's no boxing unboxing. And that's one place that gains the performance. The define method also takes in the log level and the event ID, as well as the format string. So when the logging happens, all this information has already been defined. That's another gain of the performance. What this define method return is actually an action of ilogger string exception delegate, like on line 15. This delegate could be invoked directly, just like it is in the benchmark too, but it usually would be wrapped up in another extension method, just like what I did on line 17. And that extension method was called in benchmark 3. Let's do a quick review. In logging benchmark class, on line 31, this is calling into the delegate directly. And line 38 calls into the extension method. I make them different benchmarks so that if there's anything that is caused by the extension methods, we're going to be able to spot it. And the result tells me otherwise. The extension method doesn't seem having impact on the performance at all. Eh, syntactic sugar. Now that we see the whole picture, we know that although it doesn't take too much to implement the high performance logging, it does have some disadvantages in terms of the flexibility for logging. We will have to predefine the level, the message formatting, and so on and so forth. And then there might be not that many performance gains, especially in the real scenario when providers exist. So for me, I wouldn't feel guilty every time when I write a normal ilogger logging. What's your take on it? Feel free to leave a comment. If you like this one, give me a thumb up. Please don't forget to subscribe. Keep coding, keep improving. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, take care.